Yeah, so this project was a initiative of LANL in conjunction with you know, the clinic program here at Harvey Mudd. And it started 2 years ago, so the 2010-2011 school year. And then that team started off the project and kicked it off, and we've been working from where they left off.
We're doing this for Los Alamos National Labs. It's part of their intelligent wind turbine project. So the previous team before us had already developed a numerical model, and we were originally thinking that we would simply build on that and refine it a little bit based on experimental data. And so now what we're doing is we're using their model to check to make sure that our experimental data is accurate. We are expecting a change in frequency response for the blades when they're damaged. So what we want to do right now is just show what they look like under normal, non-damaged conditions. That way, later, LANL can examine and kind of observe the turbine and see if indeed the blades are damaged or if they're acting normally. The data on the tower was accelerometer data, so when we'd impact it with a hammer, it would vibrate. The same sort of thing with the piezoelectric sensors, it appeared like an accelerometer. And the purpose was to excite the tower and all the frequencies that it would respond. So by hitting it, we could see in which frequencies it responds normally. That way we can just determine its properties and characteristics.
If the blade is damaged, then it's gonna oscillate at some sort of other frequency. So if you can compare you know, some sort of real-time monitoring of the frequencies of oscillation with an expected value, then you can write some sort of code that will, you know, light up a light and say, hey, this isn't performing as expected. Maybe we should look into this. So that's what we're looking at now.
LANL hopes to use this information to simulate damage to the turbine and then show what frequencies are the worst damage, as in, like, you need to replace this blade now and you need to fix these cracks, those sorts of things. We are working on applying our data that we've acquired in the field to our 3D model, and currently it's starting to show some vibration, which is very exciting.
The end goal of their sort of investigation is to reduce the downtime of wind turbines due to, you know, sort of maintenance issues. If they have to, you know, shut down the wind turbine and perform some sort of, you know, fix, you know, because the turbine is damaged, it's obviously not pumping out power while they're performing maintenance. And if you can reduce that time, then you are increasing total power output on the whole. So the way that they want to go about doing this is actually by identifying the damaged blades before it leads to some sort of, you know, catastrophic failure or anything like that, and then they can, you know, perform the small scale maintenance instead of the extremely large scale, time intensive, cost intensive maintenance that nobody wants to have to, you know, perform or pay for. So that's sort of the motivation for the project.
No one's really done what we've done before, so it's totally new territory, and LANL's just really excited to see what we've come up with, and everyone's just really excited because it's so new. I really love working with renewable projects. So last year I worked on NREL's team with solar energy, so I think that gets really exciting when people are working on new up-and-coming technologies that people can see directly affecting, say, our economy as a country. I think it's really helpful and useful and cool.